Hello students, today I am going to explain you chapter 3 from your textbook Flamingo, Deep Water, written by William Douglas. Introduction of this chapter. The story has been taken from the autobiography of William Douglas of Men and Mountains. In this piece, he tells us about his fear of water and how he conquered it by courage, hard work, self-determination and willpower. It also focuses on the fact that the childhood fear must never be treated lightly. If they are tackled, then they make deep in roots into one's psychology. Summary of this chapter. The writer narrates his experience. He was 10 or 11 years old when he had joined the YMCA, Young Men Christians Association swimming pool, to learn swimming. He didn't go to the Yakima River to swim as it was considered dangerous. This shows that he had developed a fear of water. William's mother would warn him not to go near the Yakima River and would discuss about drowning. He felt that the pool at YMCA was safer. The shallow area of the pool was only 2 to 3 feet deep, while the deep area was 9 feet in depth. He also got a pair of water wings to prevent drowning. He didn't like to wear swimming costumes, which exposed his thin legs. But as he was keen to swim, he gave up and wore it. William says that he had always disliked water and recounts an older experience when he was 3 or 4 years old. He went to California Beach with his father. He stood, but the strong waves knocked William down and swept over him. He was frightened, but the father knew that there was no harm. This incident instilled a fear in his subconscious mind. When he joined the swimming pool at the YMCA, the fear of water resurfaced in his mind. He gathered confidence by watching other boys swimming and tried to copy them. He started gaining confidence, but one day, while he was sitting on the edge of the swimming pool and waiting for other boys, one boy arrived who was around 18 years old and had a well-built body with rippling muscles. He seemed to be bully. The boy picked William and threw him into the deep end of the pool. William landed on the surface of the pool in the same position as he had been sitting in. His mouth was open and he didn't know swimming. He swallowed water as he sank into the pool. He was frightened, but he used his intelligence and planned to push himself up. When he reached the bottom, but William took a long time to reach the bottom of the pool. He couldn't hold his breath and felt as if his lungs would burst. When his feet touched the bottom of the pool, he gathered all his strength and jumped upwards. His movements upwards was slow, and when he opened his eyes, he saw water all around, which was yellowish in color. He got scared and tried to grab something, a rope, but he was not able to breathe and tried to scream for help, but no sound came out of his mouth. William waved his hand at the surface of the water for help, but he swallowed water and choked himself. He tried to pull his legs up, but they were very heavy and lifeless. He felt paralyzed underwater, stiff, rigid with fear. Only his heart and the pounding in his head he could feel. As a result, he went down second time. His lungs ached and he started feeling dizzy. He jumped, his feet touched the bottom of the pool, but it made no difference. When he went down for the third time, he sucked a lot of water while trying to breathe air. Then all his efforts stopped and he had a blackout. He started to float along in space and he feel that tender arms like his mother's arm are around him and he must go to sleep. He was completely overpowered by fear and eventually fainted. Thank you.